sure, there should be something fitted in there. Welcome back to Johnny's XJ.
I was a young boy. A school teacher brought into school a moped engine, and he put it into the workshop vice, and then he started it up with an old piece of rope, and the smell and the sound changed my life forever.
Okay, let's get this rear end rebuilt. Pack some grease in the bearings for the swing arm. Some in there as well. I don't suppose you can have too much grease, can you? Just drop your beer in it. So it's all nice and flush. Get your bearing seal. Make sure it's firmly in. On this bike there is a collar as well that goes in. It's going to look like fun, isn't it? Keep dropping out. So I'll leave that out for now. Just do the other side. Yep, that's in pretty tight. Now we've got to try and fit it all into the frame, haven't we? Should be fun, shouldn't it? What could possibly go wrong? Okay, so we'll put the left pivot bolt in first. It doesn't say anything about using threadlock on it, but I have clean threadlock off it. So I'm going to put a bit of threadlock on it anyway. Just a non-permanent threadlock, just to be on the safe side. We could do the other side. Just put a bit of threadlock on this one as well. And now we'll try and get the rubber boot on. I think we've got to make sure the little hole. See that little hole there? Where my thumb is? Probably not. Try and make sure that's at the bottom, I think. And probably have to lie down for this. I think that's on. So let's get the swing arm in. Oh. Actually weigh a ton. This first bolt in. It's the first pivot bolt in. We go around the other side. Second pivot bolt in. Very loosely. So that's what that looks like at the minute. shall I do now? Shall I try and get the drive shaft in? Yes. Just put this up for now. Let's try a bit of grease on the splines. Not as easy as it looks. Now is that it, or has it gone underneath? Take it out this end. Yes, I think that's what I'll do next. Try and take the shaft out this end and then put the shaft in and see how we go from there. So let's get this off again. Okay, so let's try and get the circlip off. Got it. Whew. Then what happens? Okay, so I popped it in the vise and tapped it out with the mallet. So see if we can do this. Get the circlet back on, and I can't because it's all inside there. So it's got to go on the way I was trying the first time. Okay, so I've come up with the idea of putting it all in at once. I'm going to put it all back together first. Put the drive shaft in, so that could be at the top. Oh. Like so. Put a couple of bolts back on. And hopefully I can get my finger down there. And at the same time, try and locate it into the universal joint. So let's get the axle stand and start again. Okay, so we now have it balanced on there, and I can tell you it is very heavy. So now all we've got to do is join it up down there. Wish me luck. Put a cable tie on there. So hopefully I've got a bit of manoeuvring. Well, I don't know. Maybe I will, maybe I won't. All we can do is try, isn't it? it's in. The drive shaft's in, but I need a bit more. Probably what it was in. It's not in now. It's come out. Oh. Yeah, bugger. All right, still in. Where's my torch? Not quite in there. Oh dear, somebody's not very happy. Make sure I'm trying to do something. Go and have an argument another day. Ah yes. We're in. We're in. Yes, that's it. We're locating and everybody's killing each other. See if we can locate this side. All fitted. We've just got to tighten everything up and torque it down to the specifics. Sorry about all the commotion earlier, it was just somebody having a domestic over the back. Okay, so this bolt is at 100 newton meters, and I haven't got 100 newton meters on my ratchet, so it's just foot pounds. Last time I downloaded an app, metric converter. See if we can remember what to do. So we want energy and power, don't we? Yep. And then go to Newton meters. And then type in 100, convert to 73.76. So go to 70, just over 73. And that should be our torque wrench setting. Do the left side first. That's it. Okay, the Allen bolt should be 8.8 foot pounds. That's it. Now I've got to make sure that doesn't move. I'm going to try and make sure this doesn't move. That white. So that's marked it. So if that moves, we've shot it. So let's go to 100 newton meters, 73 foot pounds. That's it. Oh, it's not moved. Thank God for that. It was nice and free. No play whatsoever. Lovely. Now we can get the shock in. Shock in. So yes, let's see the rear shock mount is under there. Trapped between the mudguard, which means we're going to have to remove the mudguard again. Lovely. Okay, so that's the mudguard pulled back. Not seeing there too well, but I'll try and get the bolt out then. There is the bolt. Now I've got to get these two spacers inside. So this should be fun. Now I've got to try and get that spacer under there. She's proving very fiddly. Simple. Okay, so let's grease all our needle bearings. Grease all our bushes. Okay, so we'll try this one first, connect it to the shock, the nuttle facing downwards, get your bolt, insert it, wipe the excess grease off, put your knot on the other side. Then the long bolt must go through the middle one with our dog bones. Put the knot on. That's it. Put the knot on. That's it. Now we just got to torque everything up. All the linkage bolts should be 48 newton meters. Is it? There we go. There we go. And a little rubber plug, what goes in there. When I first started the strip down, I did take it out and it was like brittle plastic, ready to snap it off. So what I did was, put it into some old brake fluid. Now it's all gone all soft again. How long's that been in there? 5 months? Probably. Let's see if it works. Okay then, let's see if we can't get the back wheel in. So this little baby goes in there. Even though I've had to do it twice, I still say it's easier than a chain. Okay, so the top head spacer goes in the first. Spindle axle, get ready to put outer spacer on. then in between goes the torque arm or caliper mount, spacer, or whatever you want to call it. But your shaft should go all the way in. Bit of a tap at the end. Bob's your uncle. Now there's a bolt to go through there, but I'm going to source a new one. And there's the nut and washer for the other side. So let's go around the other side. That goes on there. And that goes on there. And I'll torque that up. I'm not going to torque it up yet, just in case I've got to take it all off again. Okay, then we can stick our torsion bar on. And the same at the other end. I'm putting the bolt through this way because there's little holes and there's little split pins that go in them. So it'd be easier to put them on the outside than on the inside. Then all you have to do is put your little pins in. That's about as far as we can go today, I think. Thanks for your company. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, thumbs up, subscribe, comment, share, and see you again next Sunday.
A school teacher brought it to school. A moped engine. And he put it into the workshop bars. And then he started it up with an old piece of rope. And the smell and the sound changed my life forever.
I see you in another life, brother.